introduction about myself. I basically belong to Ghaziabad, Delhi UP border. My basic education happened in Ghaziabad till 5th class. After that, I was in Delhi till degree first year. And then I moved to Hyderabad to a traditional Gurukul. When you hear this word, Gurukul, what comes into your mind? Little loud. Oh, right. Quite similar to that. It's a traditional Gurukul, which I can, if you have seen Ramayana and Mahabharata, Rama used to study in a Gurukul and all Pandavas and Kauravas used to study in a Gurukul. It's that kind of Gurukul. We still have some such Gurukuls. It's not mere a residential school. It's a family, Guru's family, or you can say it's an extended family. Where we study, you come from a small family, you happen to be in a rather bigger family. So I studied there in a Gurukul, and basically my subject there was and that led to explore the world of computers. So from Gurukul, after doing Vyakarnacharya, studying Panini and grammar, I moved to IIIT Hyderabad to do PhD there in computational linguistics. There I applied concepts from Panini and grammar, Sanskrit grammar, for English to Hindi machine translation. I studied Sanskrit. I know Sanskrit. Now I am applying its concepts for machine translation, not to Sanskrit, but to English to Hindi or other Indian languages or any other language of the world. So this is my background. Now we will start our presentation. Let me give a little background about this presentation also. So all of us have studied some or the other language in schools, right? And we believe that human language is a logical system. Is it true? You don't believe. Okay. Do you believe? Do you think that... Okay, you don't even believe. That's a good thing. But we do believe that languages are logical system. Languages follow a logical system. But this aspect of the languages is not really covered well in the schools, the way languages are taught in the schools these days. All languages are considered as different subjects like maths, arts, or science. Spanish is a different language, English is a different language, Hindi is a different language. They follow something common. There can be something common and logical. There can be something very systematic in all these languages is not taught, right? So as a result, students also view the different languages as different systems. Therefore, unfamiliar languages push a serious problem when it comes to communicate with other language speakers. So what we are going to do is, our job is to handle, to overcome this problem. And now the situation is, you see mobile smartphones in everybody's hand. At least not one mobile, more than one mobile can be found in every home, right? So every home is equipped with technology. And we in schools do spend enough time how many years to learn languages? Some of the other languages start in the schools. You probably start in 6th class, 7th, 8th, right? At least 3 years we do spend learning languages. And we do spend time learning computers, right? And now it is, if a school doesn't teach computers, the school is considered a backward school, right? So, we are, now it is compulsory for every school to teach computers. In schools, so now the time is, it is a golden opportunity to club all these two things together to overcome the language barrier. So we can build some technology which can help us reduce this barrier. So the plan is to come up with a course on applied grammar. In this course, which we call as applied grammar, it would have two components. One is grammar, and the second component is technology. So what we do is, we apply the knowledge of grammar to handle practical problems, such as unfamiliar text comprehension and having communication with other language speakers. This is the problem at hand. And the goal of course would be sensitize the children, the students, the learners to the logical nature of the language and empower the students to overcome language barrier in their academic as well as, the focus now is on academics, but it can be extended, applied to any other field in their later life also. I hope I didn't skip too. So the proposed plan is, teach in such a way to the students this grammar plus technology, so that in 6th class, We will do two things. We will enable the students to read any language and allow them to communicate to the speakers of any other language other than their own language. So what we the plan is that in 6th class, using this grammar, I will give some examples of this grammar also, applied grammar and this technology. In 6th class, students will be able to read Sanskrit, whatever be their mother tongue, mother language, be it Hindi or Marathi or whatever. In 7th class, the student would be able to access the text in any Indian language, in his own language. Access the text from any, which might be in any other Indian language, which is not the student's own language. So student would be able to access text of any other Indian language in his own language. And in 8th class, the student would be able to access the information, the text present in any foreign language through his or her own language. So this is the plan. The other plan is enable students to communicate to any language speaker. Now how will we do it? I will show you now next. So we will have some concepts from grammar. These could be prakriti, pratyay, root and suffix. The basic idea behind prakriti, pratyay. Pada, which is subanta and tiganta, the word forms which really we find in the actual sentences, actual conversation, that the samasas, compound theory, karak and vibhaktis, you might be familiar with these terms, right? I need not explain these. Yeah, because I saw these sessions. You were all Panini last day. Yeah, first day of the workshop. Karaka and Vibhakti theory, Akanksha, Yogyata and Pravritti Nimitta. Why this this word is used in this context, in whatever context? So such concepts are going to be part of this grammar, and we will also have some suitable example sentences to discuss and familiarize students with these concepts. And the concept which will allow students to know the logical aspects of the language and also the systematic divergence. It's not true that every language has the same concepts. There are some systematic divergences also, but they are systematic. They can be taught. They can be learned. So students would be familiarized with these concepts. Now, as I said, this applied grammar has two components, which is grammar, and the other component is technology. So grammar part we have talked in previous slides. Now I'm talking about the technology part. There are two components, language accessor. You might have heard about Anusaraka. Okay, Anusaraka is a language accessor cum translation tool. I can't say it's a translation tool because it doesn't give you the output in boxes, input box, output box. It doesn't give output like that. I will show you some examples of Anusaraka also. It actually, let me just come to, I'll come back to this. This is a sample of Anusaraka output. Anusaraka does provide the given an input, it all does provide the output box also, but that is not the goal of Anusaraka. That is not its aim. That is not its spirit. It actually gives output in layers. And layers, as you go walk through the layers, you will find that the successive layers are close to the source language. So here I have, I am showing only few layers. A layer, B is hidden, C layer, D, E, F, G, H are hidden, which if you use the original tool, it's just a screenshot, you will be able to see. So these layers actually they talk about how the information is flowing across the languages, from which level to which level the information has been transferred from source language to the target language. So if you see here, if you look at the individual words, da probably would not have any meaning if you look at individually. The dog who chased the cat was black. So probably you will not, if you come just like that, you look at it, you will not be probably able to translate it into any Hindi word. So it's hyphen here. Dog could have probably two meanings. One is kutta and the other is piche lagna. Who could have translated as kaun or Joe also. Chase can be translated as picha or utkeen karna or dhancha, etc. Me can be translated as mujh, war as tha, black as kala, sham, andhera, etc. But the final layer is this kth layer, where it is actually more close to Hindi But the order of the sentence is not of Hindi. It is that of English itself. So if you read it, you can probably understand, but the order would be of English. Vah kutta jisne peecha kiya mera tha kala. Haan, Hindi probably allows, but not always. Yeah, Hindi does give you that flexibility. Yes. Yeah. Right. Yeah. So let me go back to this thing. So this was a sample output of. Yeah. So language accessor. The other tool is language communicator, where we use our own language as input, but this is not simple input. Here the words are transcribed with its specific meaning which you have in your mind. It's karak, vibhakti, pratyay and all. It is clearly written, given by the user. So it is basically an authoring tool. If you want that your thoughts, your opinion should be conveyed to other language speakers, you probably choose to translate it, or you can clearly define your language. I will give you some samples of that also, how we define it, how we give it, the input could be internally the processing happens through communicator tool. Everything is well verified by the user itself, that this is what really I want to, semantic information, everything is coded by the user. And then it becomes clear in this in their own language, then it can be easily translated to the other language. I will give you the sample of it also. Okay, so the components of applied grammar are the philosophy, the theoretical part, and the practical sessions. Philosophy, it follows the information dynamics principles, and the theoretical parts are the components of grammar which we just saw in previous slide. And it follows concepts, it's Indian grammatical tradition. And the practical sessions are these language accessor and language communicator tool, which we do give practice sessions to the students in their labs while they are learning the languages. Now, how do we comprehend unknown text? I'll give you some examples of it. The idea here is, in order to learn a new language, suppose if I am a Hindi speaker, I know what is Billi. And if somebody utters Billi, I can understand easily. But if I never heard cat, and somebody starts talking about cat, first, this word is unknown to me. Then if somebody starts talking like C-A-T is cat, C-A-T, why it is not C-A-T, why is it cat? Then it becomes one more level of additional burden on the child. Then this language doesn't follow the way my language work. That becomes one more layer of the burden on the students. So my idea, my problem is to understand the topics, the concepts that could be present if I am learning science or art or whatever, engineering. So my goal is to learn the concepts of science or engineering. Why can't I learn in my own language? Why the extra burden is put on me? So the idea here is, I have mind, I have brain, I can use it logically. So the logical part my brain does, but the part of the vocabulary, the lexicon, which is so big, I have to remember it all. This burden can be transferred to the computers. So teach only the grammatical aspects to the human being and leave the burden of the lexicon to the machine. So this is the way we are trying to share the load of learning the languages. So this is the idea. So this is an example for English to Hindi translation, or you want to access the information present in English through your mother tongue, which could be Hindi in this case. So it's not simply that there is English and you have Hindi. There is a layer in between. This layer we call e-Hindi. And what is this? E-Hindi is close to English in its grammatical structure. Hindi speakers need to know e-Hindi in order to access the information present in English. I'll give you examples with it. Now just look at this sentence, chuhe maarte hain kutte. This would be of your interest. What do you understand from this sentence? Or you guys also think about it. What is the meaning? How would you translate this sentence, chuhe maarte hain kutte? Maybe. But we don't have intonation, we have just words here. Now, what do you understand? Okay, how would you translate this? Chuhe maarte is the killer? Dogs are the killers? And chuhe to bichare victims hain. Hai na? How come? Some of you are saying is dogs are the killers and the rats are the victims, but some of you differ that no, it could be rats who are the killers and the dogs are the victims, right? And in the second sentence, chor pagda police, who is the doer? Karta kaun hai? Dono karte hain, dono pakad rahe hain. Both are the possibilities. Okay, the priority to which sentence in both possibilities, which is the probable one, highest probability? So who is karta? Let's take the first sentence. Chuhe maarte hain kutte. Who is karta? Chuha? Kutta. Okay. 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 So this is a simple, many such things happen in our mind when we try to understand this sentence, chuhe maarte hain kutta. Some of you might think, chuhon mein kahan kutton ko maarne ki yogyata hoti hai, right? Kutton mein hoti hai chuhon ko maarne ki yogyata. So therefore you consider kutta is the karta and chuhas are karma, right? And if I say, no, the rats are hybrid rats and the dogs are also hybrid, but their size has been reduced to rat size or smaller than the rat, or small, one millimeter. Yeah. Oh, no, don't go to the, yeah, that's another dimension.
Now the same dog and same real brands are there, but the universality is
Yeah. Right. True. Huh. If there could be that in future, the way the world is changing, the size and the strength of the rats could be more than the strength of the dogs. It is possible. yeah. Then, so you fantasize things. You think so many possibility, yogyata, akanksha, and so. Right. So these are the all possibilities. When you look at Hindi sentences, but the first possibility would be, first probability would be that dogs are karta, because in the current world, my world knowledge says that the dogs have the ability. Dogs mein wo yogyata hai ki wo chuho ko marte hain. This is what I see in my world now. So that is the possibility. So you will say, no, kutte karta hai aur chuhe karma hai. Similarly, here, you will say, chor ko usually police jaake pakadti, so police karta hai aur chor karma hai. Similarly, hathi, ghoda mara hathi ko probably ghoda mein marne ki kshamata nahi hai. So hathi is the karta and ghoda is the karma. Right? Now, look at their... Not, I won't say there, but look at English. When you see rats kill dogs, do you still get so many possibilities in your mind, or they just one meaning? Right? All those possibilities which were there in your mind for Hindi are not now for English. Why? Hypothetical world. Fantasy. Yeah. Oh. Yeah. Yeah. Punctuation is here. Yeah. So that possibility is also rejected. So we don't have so many possibilities here. Why? Arrangement. What is this arrangement? Right? Why does English has to do this? Grammaticality. What is that grammaticality? Right. Why it has to be so? Why can't it do like Hindi or Sanskrit or any other Indian languages? Why? Okay. Yeah. Right. Right. Okay. Actually, the idea is that languages express. Okay, come back now. Yeah. Come back to me. So actually, languages express or languages encode information in two ways. One is we use some morpheme or some expression to encode that information, or we do it by the positions of the order of the words. We arrange the words in the arrangement of the words allows you to encode some meaning. For example, if I say Raj Purush, you have one meaning, Raj Purush. If I say Purush Raj, do you have the same meaning? Meaning has changed, right? So similarly, when I say rats kill dogs, it has one meaning. When I say dogs kill rats, it has other meaning. Very different. Similar to Raj Purush and Purush Raj, why we say that Hindi allows this? Hindi allows you to reorder, shuffle the words. It doesn't. It has got some power which gives it the facility to rearrange the word, to restructure words in whatever order. That is, it has got some additional vibhaktis. And if the vibhaktis are removed, like the chuhe maarte hai kutte, you go and look at the yogyata, etc. Right? You try to look at and find out the all possibilities. You look at the context and all. And then you come up with some meaning. So, in Sanskrit, in Raja Purusha, you don't have vibhaktis. So, if you change the order, the meaning changes, Purusha Raja. If there are vibhaktis, in Sanskrit, Rajyaha Purushaha, you can say Purushaha Rajyaha, nothing changes. But the moment you remove the vibhaktis, Raja Purushaha, the internal vibhakti has been removed, Rajyaha Purusha, the ka vibhakti, Raja ka Purush, Purush Raja ka, you can say, still in Hindi also. But the moment you drop the vibhakti, you make it Raja Purusha, you cannot say Purush Raja in the same meaning. Yeah. True. I understand your point. So the thing is, until it had its own, every word had its own vibhaktis, they also were giving some unique meaning. Raja, Rajyaha Purusha, Raja Ka Purush, it has got the two words together give some unique meaning. And even if you change the order, Purushaha Rajyaha, it will still... I'm talking about both. In compound, you have removed the vibhaktis, internal vibhaktis. Yeah. So the one of the features of compounds is sublopa, which is deletion or dropping the vibhakti. Now when you drop this vibhakti, what happens? Intentions need not be different. Look at the structure of the, just look at the structure of the words involved in the compound. So when it is compared, ordered matters. The order is fixed in compounds, right? And what is the reason? What is the reason why it is fixed? Because it is talking about the same meaning. It is talking about the same meaning. When you say Rajya Purusha and when you say Raja Purusha, it is the same meaning. Okay. Okay, yeah, that's fine. Yeah, we will debate it. True. Okay, so the concepts of the grammar would be, that was an example how different languages behave differently. So now, another, based on the previous examples, also we can say that the order of the language also encodes some grammatical information. For example, subject जब इंग्लिश में आता है तो उसमें कम में क्रिया से पहले आता है और जो ऑब्जेक्ट है वो कम में क्रिया के बाद आता है. तो यदि हम ई हिंदी की बात कर रहे हैं तो आप जब चूहे मारा कुत्ते ये सेंटेंस आपको मिलेगा ई हिंदी में, तो आपको पता है कि ये क्रिया है और जो सब्जेक्ट है वो क्रिया से पहले आता है और ये ऑब्जेक्ट है वो क्रिया के बाद आता है. तो आप उससे इतनी नॉलेज यदि आपको हो गई, आप अब यही हिंदी को जब पढ़ेंगे तो आप उससे एक ही मीनिंग निकालेंगे कि यहाँ पे चूहे ही हैं जो कि कर्ता हैं और कुत्ते ही हैं जो कि कर्म हैं. जो जितनी सारी जो पॉसिबिलिटी हमको हिंदी की वजह से आ रही थी वो सारी अपने आप खत्म हो जाएंगी. सो चूहे सिमिलरली इन ऑल दीज सेंटेंसेस जो कि मल्टीपल पॉसिबिलिटीज हमको अपनी हिंदी भाषा की नॉलेज की वजह से आ रही थी विल डिसअपीयर. सिमिलरली लुक एट दीज मोर एग्जाम्पल. बच्चे प्यार करते हैं पशु, यू विल अंडरस्टैंड विच इज कर्ता विच इज कर्मा. सांप धावा किया नेवला, कृष्ण प्रहार किया मोहन, राम देखा रावण, मोहन डांट रहा है माली, मोहन का भाई रवि खा रहा है सेब. यू अंडरस्टैंड वॉट इज कर्ता, राइट? दिस इज ई हिंदी. The other concept could be sakarmak and akarmak, which is little different. So, a verb in English could be the same verb could look as transitive as well as intransitive, can behave in two ways. So, you can have a sentence, Ram opened the door. Now, looking at the verb, you can think, okay, it could be intransitive as well as transitive. Now, if you find, okay, there is an object, so though the open verb looks like intransitive, it could be transitive also here. So, depending on the context, you can go back and derive the exact meaning which is being tried to say. Ram khola darwaza or Ram और दरवाजा खुला, व्हाटएवर. राम कमरे में आया और उसने दरवाजा खोला. सच एग्जांपल सेम. अनदर ग्रामेटिकल कॉन्सेप्ट इज संज्ञा शब्द का क्रिया रूप में प्रयोग. नाउन्स बीइंग यूज्ड एज वर्ब्स. सो व्हेन यू लुक एट राम, पेन किया अपने विचार. तो यूजुअली हिंदी में उतनी ज्यादातर उससे नहीं करते जितना इंग्लिश अलाउ करती है, ठीक है? तो नाउन्स कैन बी यूज एज वर्ब. सो व्हेन यू लुक एट पेन यू कैन यूज इट एट वर्ब. पेन किया, रवि बुक किया एक मामला राम के खिलाफ, पुलिस रजिस्टर किया मामला. रजिस्टर, जस्ट रजिस्टर सर. पेन रजिस्टर बुक. हाँ जुतिया, हाँ जो पेन नाउन था उसको वर्बल सफिक्स लगा दिया और उसको वर्ब बना दिया. हाँ जी, हाँ. तो ये दोनों मिला के वर्ब का, हाँ राइट. True.
Register is okay. Register is one and now that the verb. But then there are verbs in the English that we have taken as it is. And usko Hindi simplified kiya
hai. Right. This is not Hindi, this is e-Hindi. Okay, this we have already seen. This is about language communicator. So how we give the input to the communicator tool, the authoring tool. This tool is in a very toy model right now. But this tool actually, the idea is we give input and we develop, we make some programs which will, from the input sentence, here the sentence is, Badhai ne ek sundar kursi banai hai. This is the original sentence. From that sentence, we encode all the semantic information related to that sentence in different layers, where the first layer is you encode, just separate the vibhaktis and their roots with the help of underscores or hyphens. If it is a thing vibhakti or a verbal vibhakti, you separate it with hyphen. If it is a nominal vibhakti, you separate it with underscore. And group them together, make chunks in first layer. In second layer is about the meaning disambiguation, where we give the, we have a dictionary, concept dictionary, which describes which meaning is being taken of this sentence in current context. So for I will show you the dictionary example also. So this is the dictionary. We have label, concept label, and its meaning in Hindi, meaning in English, corresponding meaning in Marathi, which is I don't have right now, in Tamil, any other language, in German, in Japanese. So this label is same and their corresponding meanings in different languages are given in these, below these columns. So from this I pick one concept which I really mean in this context. Let me go back. So Badhai ne, I am picking the first meaning of Badhai from that dictionary. From similarly, first meaning of ek, and first from for Sundar, and first for Kursi, and first for Bana also. These are chunks, how many chunks, and in this layer we encode whether this is a definite, the group that we are talking about is definite or indefinite. And then we encode their singular, plural, gender, number, person information. Here we are encoding their relationships within the group, intra-chunk relations in this row. So here, ek sundar kursi, it is saying, Badhai ne ek sundar kursi. So this is second group, ek sundar kursi, where sundar is visheshan of second group ke third word ka. Ek sundar kursi. I hope you are getting this. Second group ka 2.3rd word, kursi. Kursi ka visheshan is the first one which is coming in this sequence. The second one is also visheshan of 2.3rd also. Sundar is also visheshan of kursi itself. Now this is the next layer where we are describing the inter-chunk relationships. So here it says, in this, the third chunk has relation, this chunk has relation of K1 with third chunk, which is Banaya. So it means Badhai ne, which is this chunk, has a K1 relationship with third chunk, Banaya. Similarly, what would it mean? Right. So banaya ka relation, K2 relation, karma relation with ek sundar kursi. Okay. This is another example. This is dictionary you have already seen. This is the architecture of communicator tool, the auth pairing tool that we have been seeing just now. So here we have a Paninian universal semantic representation, which was this sentence, badhain ne ek sundar kursi banaya, etc. Similar, then we have some generators in between, and these generators will generate to Hindi, and we will have generator for Tamil, it will generate in Tamil, generator for Marathi, generator for Telugu, and similar to other Indian languages. And the same file, same representation, we have a mapper for minimal recursive semantics, it is called. It is mapped to this, and then from here we can, this can be translated to English, Japanese, Germany, etc. Okay, so the basic idea actually is, we given a natural language text, the Paninian parser comes into picture and parse text comes out, then there is human supervision. Now given your text, this parser will pass it, then it will come back to you, you supervise it, this is what really I mean, you verify it. After you verify for two things, are relations marked correctly, and lexical correspondence, dictionary meanings are marked correctly. If no, manually correct it, then send it to user verified. If yes, then directly send it here. So this is the idea, and this is what it is. In summary, I can say this is mission: overcome language barrier. And how to achieve this? We have applied grammar, which is basically a grammar plus technology, and for which we have guiding principles, information dynamics, which is inspired by Paninian grammar. And here we have all these technological part. This would be disseminated to school children. It would the idea is to make it, teach it in the schools. And similarly, along with this, we develop NLP tools. We collect the feedback from the users and enhance mutual bootstrapping, enhance the output of the tools. Now the background work is to establish proof of concept. So for that we have to conduct workshops. I along with my colleagues conducted one workshop in IIT BHU with the Kendriya Vidyalaya students, 6th, 7th, 8th students. To our surprise, when we were teaching these concepts to students were more than our expectations. They were learning it faster than what we could understand, we imagine. Yeah. Right. Yeah. And they were very enthusiastic while learning it, very cheerful. Right. So this is the method. We conduct experiments with school children for evolving pedagogical methods of teaching applied grammar, fine-tune the functionalities of the language communicator and language accessor, and examining the feasibility of the idea. So prerequisite is developing appropriate and optimal course content, which we are gradually developing while conducting these workshops with kids. Okay, so this is what it is. Right. Yeah. And so should I take it? Yeah, I'm done. Fine.